Hi, this is Mike with Harrison Consoles. This video is a quick setup guide for Windows users and was created to get you up and running quickly with Mixbus. After downloading the setup file, double-click on the icon to install Mixbus. Choose a folder where you'd like to have Mixbus installed to. After the installation, click on the icon to launch Mixbus. Mixbus expects your license key file to be installed in your home folder. If you see the Mixbus is unlicensed dialog, it indicates that the license file is not yet installed. You can click to get a new license, get help installing your license, or continue unlicensed for now. I'm going to leave these at the default. Here we can open an existing session, or we can start a new one. Let's start a new one. I'll name the session MB3 Test and save it to My Documents. Next, you'll see the Audio MIDI Setup window. You'll see this window every time you start a session. The first drop-down is for the audio setup. For Windows, we want to use ASIO. The next drop-down is a list of all available audio interfaces. These other settings I'll just leave at their defaults. The first window you'll see is the editor. I'm going to go to Menu, Window, and select Mixer. This will display the mixing window. Now, I'm going to add a channel strip so I can record, so I'll click on a blue plus button. Now I'm going to select one track. I'll come to the top of the channel strip so that I can choose the input from my audio interface that will feed this track. Right now I have a microphone plugged into my audio interface on input 1. In this case, it's already selected to channel 1, so I don't need to change anything. Now I'll come down to the lower right of the mix window to the output of my master bus. By default, Mixbus connects the master bus output to the first two sound card outputs, because it's probably where your speakers are connected. But if you want to connect a master bus to a different pair of outputs, you would select it from this list. We can use Alt-M to toggle back and forth between the mixer and the editor. To record, you'll need to arm the master record button in the transport section, and in the track you want to record to. Now you can press the spacebar and start recording. Let's rewind and play what I recorded. To locate the playhead, click anywhere in Rulers at the top of the editor and drag the playhead. Or you can use the transport controls in the upper left of the editor window. Then press the spacebar to play back your recording. To zoom or pan your track, you can grab the track header to increase the height, or you can use the View menu. Or you can use the keyboard plus and minus button to zoom in and out on the timeline. The mouse scroll wheel is another convenient way to zoom. Adding a MIDI track is nearly identical to an audio track. First, connect your MIDI device. Then launch the new track bus dialog and choose MIDI from the drop-down list. Select an instrument from the drop-down list. In this case, I'll select the included instrument, Set B Free Tone Wheel Organ. Now click Add. At the top of the MIDI channel strip, we can verify which MIDI controller will be feeding this track. To record, you'll need to arm the master record button in the transport section, and in the track you want to record to. Roll the transport and begin playing your MIDI instrument. Congratulations, you've just recorded your first tracks with Mixbus. Thanks for watching.